This episode of CleaningBiz.tv is made possible by the popular book for the cleaning industry, The Janitor, How an Unexpected Friendship Transformed a CEO and His Company. I'm Jean Hansen, and this is a show that will help turn your vision into a successful cleaning business. When it comes to growing a cleaning business, every business owner's dream is to have a steady stream of referrals. And we usually do that by joining networking groups and by asking for referrals from our contact people in the buildings we clean. But there is something going on behind the scenes every day that can help grow your business. And that is the relationship between your cleaning technicians and the people working in the buildings they clean. Now, I'll bet many of you watching right now can think of at least one employee that is just loved by the clients he or she services. We've had many over the years, employees that not only do a good job of cleaning, but always have a smile on their face and are always polite and friendly to the employees working in the buildings they clean. What has happened for us is that several times we've gotten referrals from employees who worked in the buildings we cleaned. Now, I'm not talking about our contact person. I'm talking about one of the people working in the cubicles that have nothing to do with managing the cleaning service. You see, many people really do notice when you do a good job of cleaning their building, and they do notice when you employ people that are friendly and courteous. And these people really notice when they move to a new job and see that the cleaning isn't as good as they were used to, or the cleaning technicians aren't as friendly as they're used to. Here's an example of what happened to us. We once got a referral from an employee that happened to work at a bank we cleaned. She left her job for a position at a different bank in town. Now, a couple of months later, we received a call from the bank she had moved to, and they asked us to come over and give them a proposal for cleaning two of their local branches. She gave us such a glowing recommendation that it was a breeze getting the account. Now, this bank had a total of 6 branches in town, and we eventually took over all 6. And keep in mind, this person was not a decision maker. She just noticed a big difference between us and the company doing the cleaning at her new job and suggested to the person that did manage the cleaning service that he give us a call. As you can see, it's not only the big shots you need to impress when cleaning buildings. The employees working in those buildings also notice how good of a job you're doing, and they notice the friendly behavior of your employees, so much so that they are happy to offer referrals when the opportunity arises. So how can you take advantage of this untapped resource for referrals? Well, it really starts with creating an experience for your clients. Now, there are a lot of companies that do a great job of cleaning, so the first thing you need to do is to make sure your employees are well trained on how to clean. But here is where you can make your company stand out from your competition. Most cleaning companies are in such a hurry to get new employees working on the job that they focus all their attention on training how to clean while spending little or no time training them on how to behave around clients. Now, most of us get lucky and hire a few people that actually need little or no training on customer relations. They're just naturally good at it. But most people are not. And a little training on customer relations will do wonders for your business. Let me give you just a few tips on what types of things to coach your employees on. Now, one of the things I've noticed about some cleaners is that when they come across someone working in the building, their behavior suddenly changes. It's as if they want to become invisible. So they lower their head, they remain expressionless, and they move past the person without even acknowledging them. Now, depending on the situation, they don't necessarily need to say anything to the person, especially if they're at their desk across the room busy working. But if that person looks up, instruct your cleaners to look them in the eye and smile, maybe even add a wave. Don't suddenly turn away with a stone face and make believe they didn't catch your eye. To them, the cleaner may come across as sullen and rude. Here's another example. If someone is walking toward your cleaner, tell them to keep their head up, smile at the person, and say hello. If they ignore the person, they're again going to think your cleaner is rude and maybe even a bit creepy. People aren't going to feel safe working late if the cleaners aren't friendly and approachable. And lastly, train your employees on what to do if they need to enter an office where someone is working to empty trash or do other cleaning. All they have to do is smile and ask, "Hi, is it okay if I empty your trash?" Most people are going to say sure and either hand the trash can to the cleaner or move out of the way if the trash is under their desk. As business owners, we may think that some of the things I just talked about are common sense, but if you've ever watched some of your employees, you'll quickly realize it isn't that easy for many of them. So get down to the basics when it comes to customer relations training. A simple smile and hello from one of your cleaners can make all the difference in the world to how your business is seen in the eyes of the people working in your buildings. That's it for today's show, but before I go, I just wanted to recommend a book that has given inspiration to thousands of people, and it's called The Janitor. It's the story of the relationship that develops between a janitor and the CEO of the company he cleans for. If you ever find yourself losing sight of the important things in life, I suggest you get this book. You'll find the link below this video at cleaningbiz.tv. I'm Jean Hansen, and I'd love to connect with you on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. Just look for the links at cleaningbiz.tv. See you next time.